Okay, I apologise in advance. The footage isn't going to be as stable as it normally is. There's this shit form of precipitation falling out of the sky. And my gimbal isn't waterproof. So, and I did see a car go up that way, up this track, which means they're dogging. That's not even an arm's width across, so I can't go in there. Looks dry though. Ow. The camera doesn't justify how high we are at the minute. There's that bone. Ooh. Same time, I don't want to stand on a mine or something. It's like comms cord. Expecting someone to go bang then. Good bit of wire, that is. There it is. So, having seen this, what I did was I threw Google up on my phone and had a quick look, and I came across this picture. So, having seen this, I had to ring it in. I made a call to the 50. They asked me to step away from it, which I was more than happy to do. I'm going back down. Last thing I want is for one of them to be in the ground and I stand on it, because I want to keep my legs. Plus, I think the signal's a bit better down here. The 50 are going to ring me back in a minute. But no, I just can't find the best way fucking down. Wow. Slid all that. Quick update. Right, 1 minute I'm lying in bed having a coffee. Next minute I'm on my way down back to Bickerton to show the police where this UXO is. So stay tuned. Yeah, now I can't see the I can't see the feds anywhere. So, linked up with the police. They're on the way down there now. They're coming down. I mean, it might be nothing. You know what I mean? They might just laugh at it. But at the same time, I don't know that. With the fins being detached from the body itself, it could be more unstable. And the last thing I want is you've got a scout up down the road. I don't want some kids coming and messing with it, because it looks like a... I've seen some like remains of tent equipment and things like that, see, as you can see from the video, but I just last thing we want is one kid to throw it at another kid and go bang. So let's see what happens. Right, I'm going to try and record this as incognito as possible, because I don't want to get their arses out. One of the things that you probably laugh at when you see it, but at the same time, with the fins being detached from the body itself, it looks like you've got a scout up down the road as well, you see. And I don't know if there's like remains of like tent equipment up there. You don't know if they're getting up there.
Yeah, yeah.
Next thing, one of them throws at another and...
Yeah, I mean, I can look at it. And it certainly looks like a mortar.
It's definitely a 2-inch mortar, like I've... But you get at the same time, you can tell it's been out here a while.
Yeah.
This is the way I go up.
How did you find it?
I was just mooching about, you know, and it's... There's bones on the ground. Like, but the massive bones, they really are. They look like they're off a cow.
Right.
But, carried on walking. You're all right.
Yeah.
Carried on walking a bit more and came to it.
Is it a flat way in?
It is flat. As soon as we a couple more paces, it's flat up here.
Oh,
you're right.
Yeah. I'm just thinking about. I'm going
to
get it out.
This is the flat here now. I would say from this point you're about 100 metres away from it.
Right.
There he is.
Has it been moved? It's the boat's white, so.
Yeah.
They're close
it
together.
It looks in a different position, doesn't it? But at the same time, there's a lot of badger activity up here.
Yeah. Well, elks.
Yeah. That looks like a paw print there, doesn't it?
Yeah. Yeah.
But if that part itself, I just didn't know if the charge ran through that or through that. It was like...
That's a... What do you call it? That's like the spigot, it's called a spigot.
Yeah.
With the holes in. Which when you put in the mortar, it's like a charge to get it in the air. And the holes is where the gases that come out
yeah.
of the mortar to fire it up. The charge.
Wow.
Is in the front.
Right. Because all this that all that looks intact at the front there.
This is the bangy bit.
Yeah.
And that just aids its flight.
Direction of flight. Yeah.
Accuracy. Yeah, see, it looks like.
The way I thought it was like that bit there fits into the bottom there, sticking out that end there.
Yeah, it does, yeah.
And it's.
Basically. Yeah, I did a bit of research before I came out. And I've got a match.
Yeah, definitely. That, if you have a look there, that's the same head on it. You can see the same shape on the top.
Yeah.
It's got three knobbly bits on the top with a...
Yeah, I see it. With... Yeah. Oh. Yeah. Okay. Right. EOD. Looks for them. Uh,
fair, this is only as far as I got. Towards, I didn't even.
Do you live local?
Crew.
You live in Crew?
Yeah.
Channel. Okay. That's the mortar with the person that found it. I've had a look at it and I'm satisfied that it is a World War II mortar. But EOD, I think we've got a picture on the instance anyway, but the charge, shall we say, the charge part of the mortar is probably 4 inches long, diameter probably 2 inches. It's separated from the tail section. If they want my mobile phone, I'd actually want that. Will give me a call. It's a bit of a isolated location. So it might be, I've had safety as a shout when on route.
Hey, all right. Yeah, one of your colleagues are up there now. He's give it the confirmation it is.
Is it?
And he's for EOD, like, or he said EOD, whatever that means. But he's confirmed like it is.
All right,
do
you want me to confirm it,
or? I think he's got his on, or he's using his phone and that around it, but he's. Yeah, he seems to know what he's doing.
Yeah, I think he's a specialist,
isn't it? Basically, the top of there we're going.
Yeah, I've been looking up here for a while.
Yeah.
Filming this on YouTube, mate.
What?
You put it on YouTube, mate.
Well, I don't know.
You discovered it. I was pleased to hear.
It's never. It wasn't the objective, mate. It's like I said. There's a scout up down the road.
Is there?
And with there being the remains of like tent equipment and things like that, I didn't want them getting hold of it, throwing it at each other.
Definitely. You did this at night time as well.
Yeah, yeah. Gets easier the more you do it.
That's a good little adventure.
Should have gone that way, really. Yeah, that's it. Got a nice bit of scenery for the morning.
I was thinking it was on the near the pathway.
No.
Thinking that people could see it all the time.
The size of that though.
Nice.
Well, it's you. Through the tail end of it there, and that's the main charge bit there.
Oh, yeah.
So have you ever seen that clip where he says, it was at this moment he knew he fucked up? That was me. When I got back in last night, it was about 12:30 and I was knackered. I really was. I'd been getting up at 4:30 every day that week for work and I didn't put my phone on charge. So when I went out this morning after I got the call from the police, it was like my phone was on 20%. It didn't really last that long after recording them few little segments, but I didn't expect it to go as far as it did. I didn't manage to get the part where the RLC, the bomb squad, turned up and they sorted it out. But what I did do shortly after finding that was I went down to that graveyard to film the last segment of the graveyard visit there. And it didn't fail to disappoint. What I need you to do is get some earphones, whether they're earbuds, wired earphones, whatever. Turn your volume all the way up. I'm going to try and maximise the voices as much as I can, but there was quite a few. Take a look. So I've been told to get as far away from it as possible. So I am. What? That was a bit weird. Okay, this is your last chance. This is the last time I'm coming here. If you want to say anything, feel free. What does slipper mean? I'm looking on the graves for anything that can relate to saying slip 'em. Slip 'em. Slip 'em. Christ, them lights are bright. It won't surprise me if the police come and get me out of here in a minute, because they'll want to see where that mortar is. Well, that's not them. Again, I apologise for like the unstable footage. Who did he hear talking then? I'm looking for pheasants. That's where it was, on that branch there. My head was there. And my shit trail went all the way down here. Sorry for swearing. Wow. Feel the edge of it there. Shame. I'm going to do a little walk around and then see if anything comes through on the spirit box. Can you come and walk up to me? Flight Sergeant Davidson. Wow. looking for anything that relates to slipping. Oh, bless. Can you help us to like understand what happens when we die? I don't mean that in a bad way. Closest I've just seen is that there, how it says Shenton, but it definitely said Slipham, not Shenton. Can you walk up to me or past me? Oh, bless. A little pee-pee. He's not been there long. Is he? Oh, he's stiff as a board. I don't want him being on a grave. I like rabbits. I've got one myself. It's called PP. Swap hands, I'm getting arm ache. Manners maketh man. He's going too fast. I know it sounds weird, but this side definitely feels more airy than that side.
Oh, excuse me. No way.
Donald Ginger McCain. Or Ginger's McCain. 1930 to 2011. Trainer of 4 Grand National winners. That can't be the Ginger McCain, surely. If you are, I do apologise. Well done on your success. Wow, what's going on there? That is a badger hole. You can see how some of these are just raised. And I forbid that. You get a better idea. It's like that all the way down. Oh my God, there it is. Look at it. Look at it. You nearly got me again then. You made me shit my pants. And he's gonna do it again. As soon as I move underneath him. I don't want to walk under it. Because it's going to do it, I know it is. Wait for it. You loud mouth frigger. Look at them eyes though. Oh, he's just plopped on the floor. See his stinker? I'm not going to walk under him. Oh, you fucker! He done me again. He done me. Thank you very much for all the times I've come in here and you've come through and spoke. And you've been seen, you've been heard all around the world. People have heard you. Is there anything you want to say to them? I'm going to leave you in peace now. I hate this bit. Walking through there, not knowing what's behind me. It's gone out in the church now. Don't know why, but I never get anything come through in the spirit box in there. But you always do in here. Let's give it a go. Quick one. Again, this is the last time I'm coming in here. So if anyone wants to say anything, now's the time. Ooh, see what I mean? I've got chills with that one. It's a shame I had it in my pocket.
You
laugh. Wow.
You laugh.
Wow.
You laugh.
Wow. Yes, I did. Thank you very much. Can you tell me your name? Oh God. Should I get shouted at? Can you tell me your name and what you did for this church? Sorry, 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 sorry. there anything you need me to do? That for that. A couple of things come through light, but you're never going to get constant sentences with them. And with them, I mean the spirit box, not the deceased. Thank you very much. There we go. Now time for the easy bit, the bit that takes the least energy out of me. Going back and having a listen to see if anything comes through, and if anything does, as always, I'll stick it up on the screen, make it a bit easier for you to like understand. But like I always say, if you ever think that it says anything different, I appreciate most of you have been putting in the comments bits that I've missed, bits that you think that it's saying. You see, there was this happening at this time, I heard this at that time. That's absolutely brilliant, that's what I need, because I do see every single one and I will go back and have a look and a listen. That being said, as always, I'm going to go home. I need to take these boots off, I need to get in bed, and I need a little bit of kit, because I'm getting up at like 4:30 every day this week for work, and it wipes me the out. Thank you very much to everyone who's come across from Project Dark Knight, and DK himself. I can't thank you enough for that channel shout out. That was absolutely amazing. It really was. I'm blown away. I never in a million years thought I'd get me 1,000 subscribers as quick as I did. And it's all thanks to Project Dark Knight. Depths of Despair as well. Thank you very much. I've been featured on there. But I'm going to be honest with you. I've said it before and I'll say it again, anything I catch, it's legit, it's not bullshit. I don't have a recorder with me, or I don't have another speaker. Well, I've got my EVP speaker, but I've got no way of like as I was saying, I've got no way of faking it, and I wouldn't fake it. That's not what the channel's about. It's about bringing you the truth about what happens, or maybe getting some answers about what happens after we go. You never know, we might get an answer one day. Thank you very much again. I really do appreciate it. I am going to keep trying to bring you scarier content in different locations. I am keeping my eyes to the ground, I'm keeping me ear to the ground, I'm keeping my eyes peeled. There we go. Thank you very much again, and I'll see you next time. Bye bye.